The community gathered in Milolii on Saturday to celebrate La Elima, a special day in the history of this treasured Hawaiian fishing village and the Haole Kamanao Church. As Walter Kahiva Jr. tells it, La Elima marks a day on February 5th, long ago in 1868, when a large earthquake struck Hawaii Island and sent the ocean rushing over many seaside villages along the South Kona coast.
They say a tidal wave, but in researching the backgrounds, we discovered there was no recorded tidal wave on that date. And it kind of matches with what our kupuna said. For us, tidal wave is kaimimiki. But for us, they said it was kai ko'o, rough seas. So, the entire peninsula, of which we are on the interior of right now, it's of course right on the shore, but originally we were about, perhaps 400 yards inland from where the seaside was. And the entire area was renowned for its coconut grove. The entire grove went under the sea. To this day, the boys can still swim out. They will see the coconut tree holes in the lava where the trees were.
The Haole Kamanao Church, one of 20 Hawaiian churches built by John Paris, was pushed about 300 yards inland by the rushing sea. The original location of the church is now underwater.
In the sinking process, the waves picked up the church, and with the ringing of the bell, it was carried inland to where it is right now.
Villagers later moved the church to its present-day site using palm trunks to roll it into place. Although other areas were destroyed, somehow Milolii was spared the misery experienced elsewhere.
Villages along the coastline sank. Ka sank. And sadly, because we have lots of family there, this is not a day they remember happily. We remember it happily because no one died. But Ka, hundreds of people died. A little further down, an area called Okoi, about 2,000 people died there, according to our lore. When I researched it, not too many deaths were recorded other than in Puna, where several peninsulas like Milolii sank. And of course, the loss of life there was in the thousands. But here, because no one died, and that's a rare occurrence. Always when tidal waves came, we lost people.
The kupuna from other South Kona communities joined the village in Thanksgiving, which lasted several days. The story of that day has become immortalized in the mele, La Elima, sung by Israel Kamakaviva Ole and others. But Uncle Kahiva says that not all the olelo spoken about La Elima has been true. For example, Kahiva spoke of the missing children who were led to safety in caves and rescued 5 days later.
Now, the song La Elima tells about them running into the cave to hide. And I'm afraid that song was a naughty joke played upon the people who came to ask for the words. And today you're going to hear the granddaughter of the woman who composed it. She will be singing it, that's Auntie Mille, and her niece.
At Saturday's celebration, the true family song was sung by Auntie Shirley, so authentic and special to Milolii, all in attendance were asked not to record the performance on video.
But you know, in our Hawaiian way, when people come, and you know, when people of an area compose a song for an event, it's meant for that area, it's meant for those people, it's meant for that event. But these were entertainers coming, and they wanted to go and sing it elsewhere. And so, as with Hawaiians, they always change a little bit. We did not realize that the changed version would become the official version, and the real version has still to this day remained just amongst the village people.